Choices have to be made and difficult decisions taken. At this stage of my life, I've not come here to embrace delay and denial.
And for more on the politics and the policy of the new governorship, we turn right now to KCIRA3 political reporter Kevin Riggs. A time of austerity coming our way, it sounds like, Kevin.
Yeah, Jerry Brown said during the campaign that he brought an insider's perspective and an outsider's experience as far as the governor's job, and he'll certainly need all that and all the political skills he can muster to tame a dysfunctional capital.
This land is your land.
A choir and color guard from two Oakland charter schools, part of Jerry Brown's political legacy, set the stage for his return to power, the only governor besides Earl Warren to embark on three terms. But history aside, this was a day for Brown to issue a stark assessment of California's political dysfunction.
Without the trust of the people, politics degenerates into mere spectacle, and democracy declines, leaving demagoguery and cynicism to fill the void.
Brown issued a nod to the hardships of pioneer families, including his own, that crossed the plains, an effort to put the state's current woes in perspective. But Brown made it clear that unpleasant cuts lie ahead to bridge a projected $28 billion shortfall.
It's a tough budget for tough times. When dealing with a budget gap in the tens of billions, I must point out that it's far more than waste and inefficiency that we have to take out.
Brown said he would not embrace delay and denial. After his 16-minute address, delivered without teleprompter, Brown and his wife headed out to the street.
It's a lot different. I know more. I'm older. I have less time. But I'm going to work all the faster.
Brown's tough love prescription is not likely to please anybody. It is expected to set the stage for a special election that will ask voters to extend a temporary package of tax hikes due to expire this year.
I think the public has to be prepared to have a very broad conversation about all the solutions necessary, and that extending temporary taxes obviously is part of that solution.
But putting that on the ballot would require Republican votes, a tough sell at this point.
Adding to the tax burden is not something that I think Californians are willing to think about right now.
And Brown repeated his vow today not to approve new taxes unless first approved by voters. He has told us he wants to hold that election on June the 15th. In the meantime, Brown is expected to release his so-called tough times budget a week from today on the 20th of January. Hard work now begins. Live in Old Sacramento, Kevin Riggs, KCRA 3 reports.